Welcome back. We are in conversation with the Finance Minister of India, Mr. Arun Jaitley. You also mentioned about the monetary policy. Of course, that was in the context of other countries. But back home, the Monetary Policy Committee just announced a cut in rates. Do you think that there is legroom for further reduction in rates?
Well, I won't comment on this. This is a decision which the Monetary Policy Committee and the RBI governor takes. You see, this was one of the long-awaited reforms. And the long-awaited reform was that you must have an MPC. World over, there are MPCs now. But the Indian MPC is still loaded, and rightly so, in favor of the RBI bank, because the governor has the casting vote itself. Now, they, I understand, will do the exercise, and the kind of people we have chosen as government nominees are not insiders in the government. Since we were creating a new institution, one of our objectives was to have people who have an arm's length distance from the government. In fact, the three academics who've been chosen, I still haven't met them in this context. And therefore, they operate independently, they apply their mind independently. The RBI, therefore, through the MPC, gets a lot of inputs. They will discuss data. And the relevant question is, they look at inflation from every point of view.
Right.
Now, from an inflation figure 2.5 years ago of almost 9 to 10%, you had come down and then you moved up to 6% because of food prices. Now, possibly they have seen that with a good monsoon and a bumper harvest in pulses, the vegetable and the pulse prices are going to go down. And once that happens, if the inflation goes down, obviously, the RBI has greater flexibility in taking a decision, and that's what they've done at the moment.
Well, one exercise in which you're directly involved is the budget-making exercise. Is there any clarity on the date? And also, I wanted to...
Well, I think in principle, we have decided that we would like to, as a rule, advance the date.
Okay.
And the reason why we wanted to advance the date was that we want the entire budgetary exercise to be over and the finance bill to be passed and implemented from 1st April onwards rather than June, because then the monsoon set in and effectively the expenditure starts in, say, October. We want the expenditure to start in April itself. But then this year, you have 5 state assembly elections.
Right.
So we are just trying to coordinate that you don't have to announce the budget bang in the middle of an election date. So it should be reasonably before that or after that distance away. So we'll see the concerned date and then take a decision. Though as a rule, in terms of a principle, we are in favor of advancing the date.
So I have 3 interrelated questions. What would be the implications of the Election Commission's intervention in the budget making?
You see, there is no constitutional intervention. Budget is a constitutional process.
But you could have populist measures announced,
no,
I guess.
Therefore, budget proposals must be independent of the election process itself. And therefore, a reasonable date difference would be a good safeguard for that. I am waiting for that. And therefore, once there is some clarity, we'll announce the date. In any case, we are going to start the budgetary process very soon.
On the 17th of October.
Yeah.
So what would be the implications of the finalization of the GST rollout and of the report of the FRBM?
You see, the GST rollout, if the target date is 1st of April.
Mm-hmm.
And on the 18th, 19th and 20th of this month, we are meeting in order to discuss in the GST Council the possible rates and the bands. Now, as far as the FRBM is concerned, the committee is already functioning. This year, I'm very clear, we have a 3.5% target and we'll stick to that target. Future, what happens, we'll see the report and they are going through whatever are the global best practices and then they'll be making some recommendations.
But are you open to the idea of shifting the goalpost if at all that is required?
You see, let us wait for the FRBM recommendation to come.
Well, the budget that you're going to be presenting next year, it will be an early budget. The GST would have been notified hopefully by then. The FRBM committee's recommendations would have also come in. And the distinction between planned and non-planned expenditure.
And the railways would
also be a part of the same budget. What will be your top 3 priorities? Because this is a lot to deal with at
Well,
one
I
point
can't
time.
Give you specifics because you don't discuss specifics of the budget ever. But I can only tell you that our overall policy is that as far as rural India is concerned, agriculture is concerned, infrastructure is concerned, social sector spending is concerned, I think these are all areas where we have to concentrate on. That is where further growth is possible. And therefore, we must concentrate on those areas.
Thank you.